Hello, hello everybody, it is Atomic Wolf here with another Fallout 76 related video. Of course, we are only about 6 days away from Bethesda's E3 conference 2018, and fans couldn't be even more excited. The rumors and speculation have gone haywire, and I have not seen anything like this since the Fallout 4 pre-release days, and I'm very glad to see it again, because it is times like this that you see the Fallout community in its heyday. And it's a great thing to see the fans get together and speculate, rumor, and get back to their roots. Last time we talked about how Fallout 76 was supposed to be some sort of online multiplayer, co-op, something of the sort. And I did want to follow up a little thing on that that I'm sure you've heard about as well. Look at this big mural they're putting in downtown Los Angeles for a big Fallout 76 advertisement. It features three Vault Boys walking side by side outside of a vault. And a lot of people are taking that as a hint, hint, to a possible three-player co-op multiplayer, something along the lines. But of course, we are not going to come up with a conclusion while this game is still only in its teaser stages, and I think people really need to get off that mentality. But today we are going to be talking about something I saw yesterday, and it's this little radio tower here from Fallout 4. In fact, this is a Greenbrier distress signal from Fallout 4. And it is one of the many radio towers that you can activate within the game. And if you're wondering the specifics, it is the 3SM-U81 radio tower in Fallout 4, and that does transmit the Greenbrier radio signal. What is so important about the Greenbrier radio signal? Well, the Greenbrier happens to be the name of this resort and hotel in West Virginia, which we believe Fallout 76 will be taking place in. And what brings the Enclave into this weird matter is, of course, that the Enclave was a collection of the United States' most elite, the United States' most biggest politicians, the president, the vice president, every single elitist in the United States that had some ties with the federal government went to that oil rig that we are all familiar with in Fallout 2 when the bombs fell so they can be protected, and they built up this big Enclave army that we all know today. And it also, this Greenbrier radio signal makes us think that the Greenbrier Hotel and Resort may have housed some American elites in there as well. Why? Well, I learned this yesterday, as many of us have already, that the Greenbrier Hotel and Resort back in the 1950s actually had a secret underground bunker beneath the resort to protect people of a similar class from a nuclear holocaust. In fact, I'm going to read this straight from the wiki. It is this little snippet from it. And it has a pretty, I mean, you have to think of Fallout when you read this. So hopefully this can shed some light on the subject. So right here it says, the bunker. In the late 1950s, the U.S. government approached the Greenbrier for assistance in creating a secret emergency relocation center to house Congress in the aftermath of a nuclear holocaust. The classified underground city named Project Greek Island, built at the same time as the West Virginia wing, an above-ground addition to the hotel from 1959 to 1962. Although the bunker was kept stocked with supplies for 30 years, it was never used as an emergency location, even during the Cuban Missile Crisis. The existence of the bunker was not acknowledged by the government. Ted Gupp of the Washington Post reported it in a 1992 story. Immediately after publication of the Post story, the government decommissioned the bunker. The facility has since been renovated. It is also used as a data storage facility for a private sector. It is featured as an attraction in which visitors can tour the now declassified facilities known as the bunker. So this was a place for Congress to collectively go to if there were something along the lines of a Cuban Missile Crisis or the big one as we've seen on October 23rd, 2077. And of course, after hearing this information, it sort of conflicts with it being a possibility in a Fallout game because it has been decommissioned. But at the same time, there was a huge rift in Fallout history that does not meet our own. There is an alternative timeline in Fallout, so there could have been, in fact, no decommissioning of the bunker, and it could have been used sometime during the war. And the funny part about all this is that the radio tower in Fallout 4 only emits something called the Greenbrier distress signal. It does not actually come from the Greenbrier Hotel. This is all from the the Fallout 4 location, but it does make us wonder, why is this place called the Greenbrier, a place in West Virginia where the next Fallout 76 is possibly going to take place in? But again, we have seen this kind of thing before in the Fallout series. In Fallout 3, I'm sure we all remember Harkness and the story of the first androids we come across in the entire series, later then being carried on to Fallout 4 as being one of the main topics in the game. And, you know, a lot of the times it's little details like that that gets us wondering. And of course, this has people excited, thinking that perhaps Fallout 4 hinted us at a possible return of the Enclave in Fallout 76. Am I confirming that? Is anybody confirming that? Absolutely not. Please take everything with a grain of salt until we actually see it. But of course, I love rumors and I love speculation and I like exploring that sort of thing. And this does sound exactly like something we would get in a Fallout game. A 1950s bunker underneath some resort somewhere. I mean, it can't get more Fallout than that, you know? And of course, this is where Congress was supposed to hide in the event of a nuclear attack. And of course, Fallout 76 is taking place miles before Fallout 3 and the other games we have played so far, which of course makes us wonder, oh, the Enclave should be alive and well at this time. Is this a bit of a stretch? Of course it is, but of course it's not, because of course we have seen many, many things that have carried on from one Fallout game to another. A lot of hints, a lot of little nudges have been out there to hint us about the next game in the series. Some haven't, but this is something very, very cool. And of course, I want to get your take on it. So please let me, Atomic Wolf, know in the comments what you think about this latest piece of information. We are only a little ways away from E3, and we are definitely going to get a clearer picture once they show us the bigger, fuller trailer that I'm sure will answer a lot of our questions. Give us a like, a share, and a subscribe. Check out A-Bomb Radio, the Fallout-themed radio station that plays thousands of tunes all day long, nonstop, and it's absolutely free. With that, I'm Atomic Wolf, and I'll see you guys next time.